fantastic job with it. A Sunday sun, a sea into, as we say on the reserve, to a name that means let's go. So down for their friends, my name is DeAndre. I'm going to be your driver, animal guru, and the person who will be talking a lot for the next 2 weeks. Now, before we begin, a couple of notes for you. Please do remain seated at all times for me. There's no standing up here. Keep your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the vehicle. We will be passing by lots and lots of brush, and it can be very sharp with thorns. So I don't want you getting hurt. Keep your hands inside. What animals might we see? We'll take a look above your heads. Those are the animals on the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. Now, these are wild animals. They are free roaming, which means they have the freedom to do whatever they want naturally, including sleeping or hiding or even getting in front of our truck. So we'll want to be super careful, keeping an eye out for all animals, but we might not see all of them. But do get your cameras out and have them ready for action, but hold on to them tightly, because if something falls overboard, cannot stop to pick it up at any point in time. But if you do want it back at the end, if you really, really, really want it back, let me know. See if there's something I can do for you. It will probably be a pancake by then, but hey, never know. All right, so welcome to the Harambe Wildlife Reserve, established in 1971 for conservation of the local wildlife. Very important to us because no matter how big, small, or fierce these animals, we humans are their number one threat. You're going to hear a lot about that over the next 2 weeks. Now we're coming up by a watering hole. It's a popular gathering spot for animals, even the most shy, like the black rhino. Hey, there it is. That's not its best side, though, unfortunately. Hey, black rhinos weigh about 3,000 pounds. They charge at 35 miles per hour. And they have a pointed upper lip that helps them grab food off of the nearby brush. It's kind of like an extended little finger. It just reaches out, grabs, and moves it back. Hey, there's another one. They are just a little behind today. Black rhinos, well, there aren't too many left in the wild, so I'm really, really happy we could see some today. Less than 5,000. That's due to poaching for their horns. Not true horns, though. They lack a bony center. They are made of keratin. That's the very same substance in our hair and fingernails, so it's pretty common. But unfortunately, it does go for a lot on the black market. And often, poachers will take those funds, turn them around, and find better ways to hunt these beautiful animals. The white rhinos are a little bit different than the black rhinos. They have much wider mouths, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. We have a little bit more mature to go before we head to the Sapi River. And hey, look over here to our right. A couple kinds of animals. The tan ones are the greater kudu, the second tallest antelope. The copper ones are the bardos. Greater kudu are normally nocturnal animals, at least in areas where they're hunted, but here they're fairly well protected, so they come out to say jumbo a little bit sooner. And those bongos over there, nicknamed the ghost of the forest, not because they're scary, they are quite beautiful, but they scare super, super easily. And they are typically a rare sight to see. They also have those backwardly swept horns, helping them run into the nearby bushes with ease. Uh-oh, bongo crossing. Oh no, that's okay, I'll wait. I'm patient. Bongo's on parade. Hey. All right, I'm going to call the warden and let him know. We're just going to be a little bit. No, we're just about ready to go. We're going to wait here. We'll let them go. They're peaceful creatures. It's okay, don't worry. Take your time. We have 2 weeks. They really are, aren't they? Oh, well, thank you so much, Bongos. At least they kept on moving. Didn't hold us up for too long. But there they are. Just seen a lot of butts today, aren't we? Well, we'll keep on heading towards the Safi River now, home to the Nile hippos. And oh, by the way, I will be making several stops for our animals on our two-week adventure, but I cannot stop for all animals nor for long periods of time. And I do apologize about that, but we have a schedule to keep. And although 2 weeks sounds like a long time for an adventure, believe me, it goes by very quickly when you are having fun. Here we come now into that Safi River. Let's look out for those hippos. They'll probably be in the water. They hold their breath for about 8 minutes at a time. It's the reason they are nicknamed the River Horse. Ah, there are a couple of hippos. Now, I really can't stop here. It is a blind spot for the drivers behind me because there's lots of brush there hiding my tail end. So I'll have to keep on moving, but we normally have pretty good luck finding a blown hippos up ahead to the left. That is the name for a group. So we'll keep on moving there, just like those. Keep your eyes turned towards the water. Oh man, all those hippos. Also, these grand white birds over here on the island and in the surrounding areas. These are the pigback pelicans. They get their name from the pink color appearing on their backs during their mating season. They have 8 foot wingspan, so they're pretty large birds, but still some of the smaller of the pelican species. I don't know if you can see that fuzzball there kind of in the center. It's curled up in a ball. It's a baby pink pelican. Look at those hippos. They can weigh up to 2,500 to 5,500 pounds and outrun a human on land. If you ever see them yelling, Not really a yawn. It's actually a sign of aggression. So that's when I'd head for the hills, but definitely get something faster than they are. Like I said, those big animals can outrun us. See what's around the bend here? Caution, weight limits, toll bridge, not a big fan. Thank goodness I had a light breakfast. Oh, and look out below. The Nile crocodiles are waiting for something or someone to drop in. Nile crocodiles can grow to be 20 feet long. When you see them opening their mouths, it's not to smile at you, although I'm sure they would love to invite you over for a nice dinner. That is how they cool themselves off. They are ectothermic, and their jaws snap shut at a power of 2,000 pounds per square inch. Hey, that's a lot of power putting some fear into my khaki, so I'm getting us out of there. In a while, Nile crocodiles. Making our way up to a new ecosystem. This is going to come with different plants and animals. Let's see what we can find. Ooh, I see a big tree. A very big tree with no leaves. It is the baobab tree. There it is. Baobab trees only have leaves about 3 months out of the 12 every year, but can live to be a whopping 2,000 years old. They are nicknamed the upside down tree. It looks like their roots are coming out from the tops, and legend has it, the hyenas were the first ones to plant the baobab seeds. They planted all of them upside down and have been laughing ever since. Of course, that's just legend, and those trees are right side up. And hey, explorers, here we come to my favorite part of the entire reserve. Welcome to the Serengeti grassland. This stretches for hundreds of miles across Africa and serves as a superhighway for millions of migrating animals every year. So important to all those lives, also the wild bee on the reserve are working very hard to conserve. This is where giraffes live, and I do see some Ankole cattle over there. I'll try and get you as close as possible to them. We have a little bit more to travel and lots and lots and lots of tall grass here. You might want to play hide and seek with some of the animals that live inside. They really do like to hide in there, especially those predators. And when it comes to seeing a predator in the tall grass, it might be too late before the pounce. We'll get those pictures developed. We'll try and get closer to those Ankole cattle. Beautiful landscape, though. It was made by all of the animals who live here. Okay, so giraffes, they stand to be about 20 feet tall. They spend about 16 to 20 hours every day eating, so that's a long time. And they're tall enough to reach from the trees, so they trim them when they eat from them that long period of time every day. They're kind of like the green shears. Elephants, they also want to eat from the tops, not as tall as a giraffe, though. They have to knock over the trees, making room for more trees to grow. And then smaller animals like springboks, warthogs, gazelles, they kind of act like lawnmowers, trimming the grass everywhere. In a well-balanced ecosystem, there's enough food for every kind of animal. Take a look over there to our left. Those are the sable antelopes. Hey, let's scoot up a little bit. There is a big bush over there that's kind of hiding some of the view. And then there are more trees, but that's a little bit of a better view of those sables. They are the official emblem of the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. There's one more up ahead. Most of them are reddish brown in color, being females or young males. Males get darker the older that they get. And the alpha male, well, he's more of a black. And I think I see him up here ahead. Yep, there he is. He says what goes. It's his way or the highway. And they are the official emblem of the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. So if you ever see our little emblem and it says Harambe Wildlife Reserve with an antelope on it with the big horns, that is the sable. And these big red mounds here, does anybody know what these are? Termite mounds. They're super hard, made of spit, dirt, and the ever-lovely poo. I saw a little animal over here. Oh, there it is. There's that springbok. Oh, look at the little springbok. It is fully grown now. They only grow to be about 3 feet tall, weigh 100 pounds, but these little bodies can still jump about 11 and a half feet, almost 12 in the air. There's some white-bearded wildebeest over there, and hey, there are those Ankole cattle with the massive horns. Their horns are about 5 to 6 feet long, 20 inches around at the base, but not as heavy as you might think they are for the cattle. Inside, they're kind of hollow. They have veins, and those veins help cool down the cattle when it's hot, and they also help with sinus trouble. They're pretty awful. Ankole cattle are domesticated cattle, the only domesticated cattle who live on the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. They were first domesticated by the Watusi tribe here in Africa, so that's also a nickname of theirs, Watusi cattle. Coming closer and closer. Normally they're found in groups of about 10,000 to 20,000 white-bearded wildebeest. That's a lot of wild beasts. They get their name from the Afrikaans word wild beast. That's what wildebeest means. At the time they were named, their dark faces, when we get a little bit closer, you'll be able to see them, with the horns, made them look kind of crazy. So they named them wildebeest. They thought they might have been wild beasts. They are party animals, though, very
Did
noisy. One of their nicknames is Gnu, spelled G-N-U. It's a sound that they make. Oh, I see giraffes. Oh, quite a few giraffes coming up ahead here. Looks to be a group of giraffes. A group of giraffes is known as two things, of course. A C-O-R-E-S or a tower. And I like tower better because of their size. Once again, 20 feet tall, but still, despite that size, they have as many vertebrae in their necks as we do. Seven. Theirs are just slightly larger, so that calls for a very, very powerful heart. Their hearts are about 2 feet in length, weighing up to 20 pounds. Giraffes can run at about 30 miles per hour, and they defend themselves by kicking. However, they are their most vulnerable when their necks are down and they're getting a drink of water. That's when they really have to watch out for those predators. Now, explorers, we are making our way towards Monkey Point, where the mandrills live. They are the largest and most colorful of the monkeys. They have red and blue markings on their faces, and the males have that same coloring on their butts. This will also be the start of elephant country, so we'll keep our eyes open, just in case we might see an elephant or two. If my memory serves me correct, Monkey Point should be over to the left. Of course, it's been about 2 weeks since I've been here. Did y'all make it on board? Yeah. Did we lose? vitamins are good for us. They can't be too far away. Let's go find us some elephants. Utmost safety for them if we get